Hello, welcome to another edition of the Mike Zielinski Show. I'm Mike Zielinski. I'm honored today to have two very special guests. To my immediate right is Larry Zerbe. Welcome, Larry. Larry is the Director of Tennis and Education at COR, which is stands for City of Reading Tennis Program, which is operated by the Reading, I'm going to get this right, Recreation Commission.
Correct.
And to Larry's right is Tyler Washington, who has a couple of alums here. He's an alum of BCTV, was a technician here after being an intern. Mm-hmm. He's now opening up his own production company. Yeah. But he's also an alum of the COR Tennis Program and a coach there. And welcome, Tyler.
Thank you.
This is a really cool program that COR is. And I know Larry's very passionate because it exposes kids to tennis, but so much more. It really broadens horizons. So do you want to give a quick overview, Larry, about COR?
Sure. COR Tennis took the baton from what used to be called the Pepsi-Cola Tennis Summer Program. And so 13 years ago, the gentleman that owns Falmouth Tennis, his name is Pat Shields, met with the Reading Rec Commission and decided to do a summer program. And that summer program then became what you see now, where we expose children in the elementary schools from third grade up to the game while they're in school. We do the middle schools in the city of Reading, and we also have a dynamic summer program. And our program now is 12 months a year. And one of our really strong points is it's tennis for all. So for all walks of life, because tennis really isn't a very common sport here in the city.
Over the years, it's kind of discriminated fiscally and culturally to a degree, right?
Yes.
Especially with inner city kids.
Yes. It's without question, there has been the United States Tennis Association, which is one of our strongest partners, has opened a lot more doors for people to be able to participate because they fund programs like ours.
Yeah.
And in turn, our young people have to do some things with academics. They have to write an essay, an Arthur Ashe essay contest. And we have to do some things that are gonna keep our status strong. And we are one of the strongest in the nation, which we're really proud of.
Well, congratulations. As an alum of the program, what has it done for you on and off the court, Tyler?
That's a long list. I got involved with the program.
It's only a half hour show.
Yeah. I got involved with the program before it was the COR Tennis Program. I've been playing for about 18 years now, so watching the evolution was pretty insane. I was a baseball player, so by the time I got to high school, I had to make a choice, baseball or tennis. And tennis just opened up a lot more doors. I got to be more involved with people. It was more one-on-one than with baseball. You traveled with a large team, and you didn't get to really meet a lot of people. And so with COR, we were going to Maryland to, I think we met the one of Serena and Venus's coaches, met James Blake, met a lot of different people, and got to see a lot more places and things that weren't necessarily going to be introduced to me otherwise. So the sport just really opened doors to my future. Honestly.
Yeah. Oh, awesome. You know, you take the kids a lot of places, as you referenced. I know you go to Philadelphia Cricket Club so the kids can play in tennis. You go to Philadelphia Freedom World Team Tennis matches in Philly. But every year you take the kids to the U.S. Open, which is really awesome. What an experience that is. And I think we have a video clip of, was this this past year's?
This was this year's United States Open in New York City.
All right.
And we were blessed to have not only to visit, but every child that went with us got to bring a family member. And each one of our players from COR got to be on the courts playing. And two of them got to do coin flips before a match with the pros. So it was really more dynamic this year than ever.
Oh, wow.
And so the video that you'll see, you know, will depict a lot of what we did.
All right, let's roll that video, please.
The bus driver has a few things to let you know about. Can you hear me?
Yep.
My name is Trey, I'm happy to be your bus driver.
We'll be right back.
know, if that doesn't motivate a young tennis player to really embrace the sport and see what is out in the world beyond the city of Reading, nothing does. And I should say that COR is the prime sponsor is from tennis. And I also would like to point out that you guys do so much more than tennis. Your programs increase wellness, self-esteem, and teach life skills. And you have a great relationship with the Reading School District. And your primary focus is on the inner city schools. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, suburban kids in your after-school programs are welcome to participate. And tell me a little bit, Larry, how that the interaction between the suburban kids and the inner city kids kind of like breaks down maybe some cultural divide.
Yes, you know, tennis, as we spoke about earlier, already has the ability to discriminate fiscally and culturally and socially based on the fact that it's just not that common in the city. So when we started to develop this program, we ended up having some really talented players. So tennis players gravitate toward the best tennis players. So there was a time when we thought that building the bridges to get these kids outside of Reading was the most important thing. Mm-hmm. So that's why we were in Washington, D.C. at the Champion Center, U.S. Open, Philadelphia. We would take them to play wherever. And all of a sudden, a dynamic happened that we weren't planning on. All of a sudden, all these kids from the Exeters, the Wilsons, the Wyomissings, the Fleetwoods, the Topahawkins, the Schuylkill Valleys ended up coming to Reading. So not only did the bridges going out of our city get a little smaller, the ones coming in got a little smaller. And that was something we just, and then there's been some lifelong friendships developed that would have never happened.
Oh, that's really awesome. You know, I know you guys have developed a lot of outstanding scholastic and collegiate tennis players, mm-hmm. but you also have fostered all these great community relations. Tyler, is that something, because when you were involved with the program, did you get to become friends with some of the suburban tennis players?
Oh, yeah, as you said.
Because you're a Reading kid, I assume.
Yeah, right? I graduated from Reading High in 2011. I played all 4 years up at Reading High. I played 5, 3, and then 1 for 2 years as far as positions on the team went. So
you made it to number one, and Larry taught you well, right?
Yeah. So those last 2 years especially, I had a couple players from the area reach out to me and want to hit during the summer, and they kind of even mentored me. And molded my game a little further in ways that I wasn't thinking about before, and it just became fun. You know, a lot of these other sports, you know, AAU basketball, when the kids are going to play, the Wilsons and everybody, they played on the same team before. They played against each other,
yeah,
and they
yeah.
knew each other. But that wasn't really happening with tennis, at least when I first started. But as the sport grew, as the program grew, and we started seeing more people, it was cool to go to these other schools and have these friendships and relationships. It definitely changed the way of thinking. And I went to tennis camps, and the kids from the tennis camps were like, oh, you're from Reading. And they always had that negative connotation. Then by the time I left the program where I was leaving those camps, everyone was just like, you know, everything I was thinking about Reading is just wrong. Like, they really became more open-minded.
Yeah, but, and really in a lot of ways, it's very unfortunate, some of the negative perceptions of Reading that are not true in many ways, including a lot of people who live in Berks County suburbs, mm-hmm. which is unfortunate. And hopefully, in time, I think it's changing. You know, we do have another video which really explains, Larry, what your program does with the elementary and intermediate school in the city of Reading.
Right. What you'll see here, the United States Tennis Association is one of our biggest partners. That's a national organization that funds programs across the country. We have been selected as one of the top programs in our country.
Congratulations.
What you'll see here is a video that they put together that is combining our elementary school program with our middle school program, and the Northwest Middle School gym is the setting for this, and it was a conflagration of all of what we've done all in one gym, and I think the USTA did a really nice job of sharing the story, so I think you'll like watching what the USTA has done.
Awesome. Can we please roll that tape?
For years, school gymnasiums have been synonymous with footwork drills, basketball, even floor hockey. But in Reading, PA, gyms are becoming more and more known for tennis.
Court tennis has been a development over the years that has allowed us to not only get into schools, but also bridge the gaps for first generation tennis players. So our elementary school program is feeding our middle schools. And today was about the all-stars of all the elementary schools in our league, which we have six, and the four middle schools coming together along with the Reading High School team, and they got to see where they could possibly be.
Transforming a gym into a tennis facility takes a team. But Zerbe, the core coaches and volunteers can have a gym ready to go in minutes.
Beyond the realm of phys ed, hand-eye coordination, timing, footwork, their gross motor skills with bounce and hit, with the hand-eye coordination. But outside of that, their communication. If they're gonna miss practice, they still tell you. Our practices start at 7:15 in the morning. If I'm late or stuck in traffic because it gets hectic driving sometimes, they're banging on the door wanting in.
I like to play tennis because we get to practice on our team.
I think today was awesome. I'm so excited to come and watch Larry Zerbe and COR and all the kids just having a fantastic time playing tennis and competing, understanding that tennis is not just drills.
When these kids play, it takes their concentration. They're so focused, and they have so much energy that they get to disperse.
What we've been able to do in these city schools without having courts outside the school, we've been able to do everything within the gymnasium. We've modified to adapt to each school, the number of courts that we can put out. We can accommodate way more students, but in some of these smaller ones, again, we make do. The kids do an awesome job. Often people say, why do you do tennis before school? And it's really the kids responded to it, the kids love it, and it's something we've grown into.
These kids want to belong to something, and tennis is something a little different. And what gets me is they're showing up at 7:15, 7:15 a.m. and the joy in their faces when they get their racket, they start to understand that the game is for them. It just makes it easy to know that next year we're going to do it a little bit.
You know, it takes a lot to motivate a kid to get up and be there at 7:15 in the morning. So I think that speaks volumes about how much these kids love it. And tell us a little bit, there's a ripple effect, not just for them personally, but it moves upward generation-wise. It used to be, you know, I know my father used to play tennis with me, and then I would play with my sons. But it's kind of like the inverse with the kids you work with, right?
Yes, you know, both Tyler and I can talk about this. What's happening now is the 5-year-old or the 8-year-old is inspiring their older siblings or their mother or grandmother or grandfather or aunts, whoever's bringing them. And whenever they come to our tennis courts, and if I see that they have sneakers on, we bring the family out. It's an old adage, the family that plays together kind of stays together. And that's one of our goals. And to date, our adult program is bigger than it's ever been. And I would say 80% of them were because their little son, daughters, or granddaughters played, and then they fell in love with the game. So, it really is neat where the inspiration came from, as opposed to before when things were handed down.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's been the beautiful thing.
That is awesome. Of course, you know, it has so much positive effects in getting the families bonded. But every now and then there's a glitch, right, Tyler? Tell us about your dad who started playing tennis because you were playing tennis.
Yeah, so my dad was just really athletic type of guy. We would go out every once in a while and play, and he would just pick up the racket, and he kind of got it. It would drive me crazy, but I was trying to get him involved with the program a little more, and he came up one day. It was one of the days that I happened not to be at the adult sessions. I think he went up with my mom, and they're working on split steps. I think you were running the drill. Goes to split step, get ready, and just boom, Achilles.
Ooh.
right before a trip down to Kentucky, too.
Oh, that's a shame. But you know what? It's kind of ironic, but you know there are injuries in sports. But Jamie Eusebius, when I was sports editor of the Reading Eagle, Jamie, and he still is, their tennis writer, so I think he's now assistant sports editor as well. But he was a tennis player and very good. And he got injured, ruptured his Achilles tendon, walking down Penn Street, stepping off a curb. So you can get hurt anywhere.
Yeah, the fun part about all that is our program promotes, you could be the best in the county, but when you come to play with COR, you may have that day an opportunity to play with somebody that might be 8 years old. And because youngsters like Tyler came through and they were older kids always willing to play with him, that's one of our tenets. So if you're a little bit of a prima donna or you can only hit with the best kids around, COR's not for you.
Yeah.
However, that's rarely the case. And the beauty is, it's a Billie Jean King adage, like if they see it, then they believe they can do it. And that's what they promoted with like Serena Williams and Venus Williams years ago. And now you just see more and more people believing like, hey, that is for me. It's not just for the people on the other side of the river. You know, I can do this because my cousin does it. Because I did it in elementary school.
Yeah.
Oh, I won the 10th flight in the city championships in fifth grade. That's why we promote so much of it at a younger age. And it just flourishes.
What's the hardest thing, like some kids may have, when you're learning to play tennis well, is it some people, the eye-hand coordination aspect of it? Because sometimes some kids just don't have it. Can you develop eye-hand coordination through repetition?
I believe so. I think the way we start off most of our, especially introducing it to the elementary school kids, is we do drills for up and down, and we really focus on getting that hand-eye coordination going. That can be the most difficult part is the success. I think was probably the hardest part early on, but the way that the USTA has now developed their program, it used to be 5 years old with an adult-sized racket with a fully like pressurized ball that would just fly, and now we have these balls that are 25% pressurized, 50, 75, and they're becoming more successful. They can hit it, get over the net, and get the ball back, and it's just a lot more fun.
Yeah, and you know, and plus it encourages them to keep playing. You know, it's like the Little League syndrome, the kid who's young and is starting to strike out a lot, you know, if he quits prematurely, he'll never know if he could have been good.
Right.
Because they walk, you know, because, you know, it's that sense of failure. So I like that a lot, you know. Tell us about some other positive things that, you know, over the years you've experienced with us, Larry.
Well, you know, the Reading Recreation Commission, you know, provides, you know, like, volleyball, swim lessons. They have like girls leadership. They have pickleball for the older generation.
Yeah, that's becoming a new thing. Yeah.
you know, they have like open gym nights for kids to come down and play basketball and stuff. So there's so many options out there. Tennis is just one of them.
And basketball, obviously, and you played basketball at Reading High.
Right.
I mean, everybody.
Well, you don't have to. Yeah, yeah.
Group centric.
We had to sell tennis.
Yeah.
The most important part about tennis is a lot of our young people are used to groups coming in, like especially around the holidays and stuff, doing beautiful things and dropping off stuff and then say, see you next year. I think that one of the things that I learned is they don't really care about how much you know. They get connected when they know how much you care.
Mm-hmm.
So at times they would be saying, mister, you're going to come, what do I get? And we would entice them with like, here's a tennis ball, here's a little racket. But now what they get is, we'll see you next week. And we're never going to go away.
Yeah,
and that's all they want. So for me, that was the most compelling piece of information that I got to understand. So they know we're coming back. That's all they want to know.
You know, it's interesting, Larry, because you were a basketball guy yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You played at Reading High under Jim Gano, right?
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
And back when, well, Reading High is still Reading High, but back then it was really Reading High hoops. And you've you coached college basketball.
Uh-huh.
But you also were the former tennis coach at Auvergne.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't start playing tennis till you were a senior in high school. That's because the gym teacher kind of made you.
Yeah,
well, that kind of changed your life in retrospect, right?
It was a blessing that I had what was called advanced phys ed. That means I had eight gyms. Eight gyms, two of mine, and I would help because I was moving on to be a teacher.
So you didn't have to go to school or what?
Well, there was something to be said for that. But the gym teacher said, you know, she would make me play some of the kids on the team. And because of where I lived in Oak Brook, no one played, and it was embarrassing to play. So I beat some of the kids on the team, and she said, if you don't pass gym, you don't get to go to Alvernia to play basketball. I said, I'm passing gym.
That's right, you played Alvernia, too.
But she sort of conned me into it. I met a beautiful gentleman named Leon Schultz. And thank goodness, because tennis then became another part of my life.
Leon Schultz, I've heard of that name.
Yeah, he's been the tennis coach up there, and his wife, Frau Schultz, taught German in the Reading School District for like eons.
Oh, okay.
So it was through inspiration that I got to play, and now we have a chance to inspire others.
Yeah, and Tyler, you came from a baseball background and then transitioned to tennis.
Yeah, I was doing baseball. I was doing the Reading RAL. I was doing RAL up at Rotary Park.
Yeah.
And what happened was I was part of the latchkey program at Riverside, and during the summers they would spend some time at Bear Park playing in the tennis program down there, and I wanted to see my friends. And that was primarily the reason I got into it. I was like, I'm going to go see my friends.
Yeah.
And then Coach Moore was just like, well, we also run it up at Albright. You should come to those programs because they're a little more advanced or whatever. And the next thing you know, 18 years later, I'm still playing, and it's been a lifelong sport.
How many kids would you say are involved in a program?
You mean currently or overall?
Currently.
We probably reach, because of all the schools, we will leave a gym this week and have met over 350 kids this week.
Wow.
So the unique visitors are up in the thousands, but the ones that are committed and that this is their thing, I would say there's somewhere between 30 and 65 kids that do this year round, that this is their sport.
Yeah.
Well, just within the city of Reading, not counting the other county kids, that it becomes part of their normal basis.
And what about how many staff do you have or volunteers?
Well, we piecemeal everything. You know, we're part time, but we have, at all times, we have at least four coaches. In the summer, we have 18 coaches, and that had to do with Merv Heller, who used to be their USTA president.
Oh, yeah, I knew Merv.
And the Burst County Community Foundation, we must give them a lot of support as well, because they also support our whole summer program based on Merv Heller and a number of beautiful people who started a foundation for us.
Now, if people want more information, to be a sponsor or to sign up, what's your website?
www.readingrec.org. Please go check out the readingrec.org website. There's so many things. And if tennis isn't your thing, there's so many other options. And if you have a daughter, son, granddaughter, grandson, and they're not connected to anything active, please do yourself a favor and check out the readingrec.org site, because there's so much to do. If you're bored in Reading, that means you're not looking enough because there's so much stuff to do.
Yeah,
And give me a call. I'll help you out anytime.
Yeah. Well, that's a good advice, it's just amazing what you have done, and you've been doing it since 2006, right, Larry?
Yes.
And this is a part-time gig for you that's turned almost full-time?
No, it was a part-time.
It's full-time now?
That became full-time, again, based on some benevolence from Frommuth and Pat Shields. But it takes a village to do this, you know, having a young man like him come back and give time is really, really important, so.
Yeah, and you know, we only have a minute left. I just thought of one other question. Does it cost the kids anything?
It is, for some families, no. For others, our summer program is probably $1.88 a day. And we run it for the whole summer, and they get lunch and arts and crafts and a reading program. So it is not cost prohibitive. If it's tough financially, we find a way.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, congratulations, Larry and Tyler. This is a fantastic program, and I'm so happy that we had a chance to spotlight CORE Tennis here on the Mike Zielinski Show.
We appreciate you a lot.
All right. Take care, guys. Best of luck. Happy holidays. And for now, this is Mike Zielinski saying goodbye.